Hello friends, cladding is the application of one material applied over another to provide a skin or layer. In construction, cladding is used to provide a degree of thermal insulation and weather resistance and to improve the appearance of buildings. Cladding can be made of wood, metal, brick, vinyl and composite materials that can include aluminium, blends of cement and recycled polystyrene or rice straw fibers. In this video, we will see the differences between wet cladding and dry cladding. So let us start. Concept. In case of wet cladding, the stone or tile is pasted on wall with the help of adhesive or a liquid latex combined with a cement based filler powder. Whereas dry cladding involves drilling holes into the surface, fixing the anchoring system, installation of framework, cutting the stone in matrix or drilling holes, fixing of clamps and then installation of tile or stone. Strength. In case of wet cladding, the bonding of tile or stone to the surface will depend on the tensile strength of adhesive. Whereas in case of dry wall cladding, the bonding of tile or stone to the surface will depend on the anchor grout pull-off strength with the surface matrix. Drilling. In case of wet cladding, no on-site drilling is required. This removes the possibility of cracking or breaking the tiles. Whereas, in case of dry cladding, the drilling is the part of fixing the tiles. Hence, there are chances for the occurrence of cracks on the substrate. Safety. In case of wet cladding, if good recommended adhesive is not used, then the bond between the wall and adhesive or mortar can become weak. And then there are chances that the stone can fall off. On the other hand, the dry cladding method is safe and chances of stone falling down at a later date are remote. The stone stays for a long life without falling off. Time. Wet cladding method is easy but it consumes a lot of time. Whereas dry cladding is a time saving procedure. Also, the installation of mechanical cladding can be more convenient and fast. Expansion and contraction. Due to the edge-to-edge bonding, there is no room for later expansion, which could result in buckling of natural stone. Hence, this method requires adequate expansion and contraction joints. On the other hand, in case of dry cladding method, the stone joints are sealed with weatherproof silicone sealant. The whole system has some kind of elasticity, which can eliminate the influence of expansion and contraction caused by temperature or displacement of the main structure. Tile thickness. In case of wet cladding, the tile thickness is less as compared to dry cladding. The reason is, if we increase the thickness of tile, the weight of the tile also increases, and due to this, the tile or stone can fall down. On the other hand, the stone required for dry cladding must be thick, because this method requires holes to be drilled and mechanical ties or anchors to be used, which could increase the occurrence of cracks. Bond between stone and cladding. In case of wet cladding, bond between the stone and cladding is entirely made throughout the area. No space is left between them. Whereas in case of dry cladding, there is a gap of around 30 to 45 mm minimum between the wall and tile, providing a layer of air cushion that acts as a thermal barrier. But water or moisture can also enter from here and may cause staining to the tile or stone. Additionally, this gap also leads to the hiding space to dangerous creatures like snakes, etc. Support. In case of wet cladding, proper support to the tile or stone shall be provided during its initial setting time. Whereas in case of dry cladding, there is no need of such kind of support. Labor. Wet cladding can be done by normal labor and it doesn't require high-skilled labor. Whereas in case of dry cladding, high-skilled labor is required to drill the holes or notch properly in the tile or stone. If the holes are not drilled properly, then it can waste the material. Color change. If good recommended adhesive is not used, then adhesive can change the tile or stone color. Also, the stone fixed with mortar may change the color due to absorption of water from back mortar layer. whereas in case of drywall cladding, there is no such problem. Maintenance. In case of wet cladding, only one damaged tile or stone can be replaced very easily. Whereas in case of dry cladding, it is not possible to replace one damaged tile or stone. So when one tile fails, many of the tile or stone shall be removed and fixed again. Use. Wet wall cladding is basically used in bathroom area where water is used all the time. Whereas dry stone cladding can be used mostly on the exterior portion of the building. Cost. The cost of wet cladding is less as compared to dry cladding, whereas dry cladding is an expensive method. So friends, see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.